I want to do is show you what happens when we put carbohydrates in your body, what happens to your blood sugar. Because remember, all these foods will get broken down to sugar. So let's have a little look at a graph. And what I've done here is called this the blood sugar level in your bloodstream, so how much sugar there is hanging around. And your body will do everything it can to keep it between 3 and 7. Now, when your blood sugar starts to rise, so just after you've had something sweet to eat, you start getting, you can actually get increased concentration. Pretty short-lived, but you can do. Some people get anxious. Some people find that they get irritable and cranky. Big bowl of pasta, a lot of people get sleepy. And you start to make fat once your blood sugar goes really high. Also, when your blood sugar starts going above this line, above 7, so maybe if you had a can of Coke or a whole stack of foods off this list, the carbohydrate list, so lots of fruit, apart from making fat, your insulin goes up. When your insulin goes up, you push your cortisol up and you definitely make fat. And if you're a woman, you make testosterone. When your blood sugar goes low, so if you haven't eaten for a while, you can get a bit vague. Some people get dizzy, headaches. Blurred vision is common, vision problems. Just drop your motivation, can't be bothered doing anything, just want to lie around. Can get a little bit depressed, can get a bit sleepy. You start craving carbohydrates, so you crave something off there. So you might crave a glass of wine or a piece of fruit or chocolate or cake. So you crave carbs, stimulants, so you might crave a coffee or an energy drink. And an interesting thing happens, you start to make fat. So that's even when your blood sugar level goes low. So what we want to try and do is keep away from these extremes. Now what I want to do is show you an average diet and why the average diet will not work if you want to lose weight or if you want to have good energy levels. So let's say for breakfast, person has a bowl of cereal, which is predominantly carbohydrate. So that's going to give their body a stack of sugar. They might have a piece of fruit or some fruit juice and a coffee to go with it. All sugary-giving foods. So you might wake up and your blood sugar might be 3.8, and you're about to have a stack of sugar, so that'll go up, carbohydrates. Then about half an hour later or so, as the insulin kicks in, you'll be feeling a little bit sleepy, so you're getting to work, so you want a coffee and a little Tim Tam or a biscuit or something, and your blood sugar will go up, then your insulin will kick in, then you'll, I've just put 1 o'clock in there. Then you'll be hanging to go to lunch, and often people sprint off to lunch because they're feeling really vague. They know they haven't been productive at work, and they'll grab themselves a wrap or a big fat focaccia or fried rice or pasta. Blood sugar goes up, they get around about 3 o'clock, everyone wants a little bit of a cat nap in the office, and that's why they'll go and get another coffee or a cup of tea, another biscuit, see themselves out the door, they'll get home, they have a glass of wine. So you can see there, even though the diet's not too bad, the carbohydrate load of it is, and people will do this all day long and they'll make fat. So even if they're following that pyramid that we used to recommend, they will put on weight. So what you've got to do is break that cycle. And the best way to break it, it's very easy. All you need to do is change the hormone response. So if you start eating proteins when you have the sugar-giving foods, so something of this list, the proteins, when you eat something from this list, so marry those two together, you get a very different picture with your blood sugar. So let's just say this person woke up and they had omelette, so some proteins, and they might have had some tomato and mushroom. This will typically happen. So they don't get a massive rise in blood sugar. If they don't eat at that point, the blood sugar will continue to go down. So I usually suggest a couple of hours after you've had brekkie or any meal really, some nuts and seeds. So we want to get something off this list and marry it with something on this list. So it might be an egg, or it might be some nuts, and it might be a piece of fruit. It might be some leftover vegetables and some chia seeds. Blood sugar will go like that. Once again, if you don't eat, it will start to drop off. So you want to have a nice little meal there. Maybe for lunch you might have tin of tuna and some salad or leftovers, casserole, stir fry. Afternoon, really important around here to either have a bar. These are the things I'm hooking into at the moment. They're just an organic bar that have high protein and quite a few nuts and seeds in there, and that just carries you through. And dinner, always nice piece of protein with lots and lots of veggies and salad. Now you can see there what happens. Effectively, you stop this massive insulin swing. So you stop gaining weight. In fact, by keeping your blood sugar between 4 and 5, just by having protein carb, what happens is you lose weight. Your energy levels go up, you feel fantastic, you stop craving carbs, you stop craving stimulants, and you feel fantastic. So it's very easy. So just remember that the key thing to it is protein plus carb. So if you're going to eat something on that left-hand column, you must marry it with something on this column. Eat them together. That might be rice cake, nuts, seeds are brilliant, fig balls, bliss balls, salads with meat, always combining protein and carb. Anyway, I hope that's been helpful.